Next, let's talk about how XFS uses the memories available in the clients for cooperatively caching the files and reducing the stress on the management of data files. In XFS, as opposed to the traditional Unix file system, they also worry about the coherence of files. I mentioned earlier that in Unix file system, the file server assumes that it is serving each client independently, and therefore it doesn't worry about sharing of files. If a particular file happens to be accessed by multiple users at the same time, the server doesn't worry about the coherence of that file. But on the other hand, in XFS, the file system worries about cache coherence. And I've already introduced the idea of cache coherence in the context of multiprocessors and distributed shared memory. So you're familiar with the terminology single writer and multiple readers, meaning that a particular file may have at any point of time only a single writer. There cannot be multiple writers to the same file, but it can have multiple readers at the same time. And the unit of cache coherence that XFS maintains is at the level of file blocks, not an entire file, but at the level of individual file blocks. So if you look at a manager for a file, the guy that is responsible for the metadata management for the file, it has information about the files for which it is the manager. Let's say it has a file F1 for which it is the manager. Then the metadata in the memory of this manager will have information about the current state of that file. For instance, this particular entry says that a file F1 managed by this manager is being read concurrently by two different clients, C1 and C2. So there are two different clients, C1 and C2, and they have copies of this file that they have retrieved from this manager at some point of time, which means that the client caches, C1 and C2, contain the contents of this file. Now, for simplicity, I'm showing this as a file, but in fact, the granularity at which the coherence and information about files is kept is at a file block level. So at a block level, the manager says a particular block of a file is in the cache of client C1 and in the cache of client C2. And here I'm using the word cache to mean that it is in the memory of these clients. So the semantics that is observed for cache coherence, a single writer, multiple readers. So if client C3 makes a request to the manager for writing to this file, F1, and again, I have to mention that the request is going to be at the granularity of a file block, but for simplicity, I'm showing it as a write request for this file F1. But you understand that the granularity at which this request is being made is for writing a particular block of that file. So the manager gets this write request. It looks up the metadata for that particular file, and it sees that this file is now currently read shared by two different clients, C1 and C2. This guy wants to write to the file. That results in a conflict, a read-write conflict. And what the manager is going to do is basically say, well, if somebody wants to write to that file, I have to tell the guys that currently have the file, they cannot have it anymore. So just as in the case of cache coherence in a multiprocessor, this manager is going to send an invalidation message for the file F1 to C1 and to C2. And they're going to acknowledge to the manager saying that, yes, we've invalidated our local copies of the files. And once the manager gets that indication back from the clients, at that point, the manager can tell the client C3 that, okay, now we've got dibs on writing to this file. That's the protocol that is being observed in XFS to keep the copies of the files consistent. So at the end of this exchange, C3 will have the right to write to this particular file. Now, how long does it have that privilege? Well, the write request, when it is granted, the client gets a token, and the manager at any point of time can revoke the token that it has given to C3. And this in particular will happen when a future read for the same file comes to the manager. At that point, the manager will go to C3 and say, I'm revoking the token from you. You cannot write to that file anymore. You can read it because the request that I got is only a read request, and therefore You can keep the file, but you cannot write to it anymore. If you want to write it again, then you have to make a request again. This is the protocol that is observed. And of course, if a particular client is writing to a file and another client also wants to write to the same file, at that point, the manager once again is going to revoke the token, invalidate the file at this client, pull back the contents of the file, and then distribute it to a future requester who wants to write to the same file. That's how cache coherence works. And using the fact that copies of the file is existing in multiple clients, XFS exploits that fact to do cooperative caching. What that means is that if a client is currently having a copy of the file, let's say after this interchange, C3 has a copy of the file that it is also writing to, a future read request comes. When it comes, that read request can be satisfied by getting the contents of the file from the cache of C3. And that is what cooperative caching is all about, where instead of going to the disk to retrieve the file, we can actually get the file content from the cache of one of the clients that happens to have a copy of the file.